Yes, give yourself square.
Okay. Graham, stop telling them our square. Graham, stop telling them our square.
It's a lot of motion, it's a lot of talking, it's a lot of paper, it's a lot of whiteboards and markers and erasers and just things going everywhere.
Oh no, math problems are flying.
It's kids having fun doing math, and that's the goal.
Oh, that's 16, yes.
I love it.
Yes.
My mission is for all of my students to feel welcome and enjoy what they're doing. The kids that I'm lucky enough to have really want to push themselves in math. 100 squares challenge. I usually will do at the end of a block or as review, so the day before test. I project a basic 100 square board. I pulled questions from worksheets that I would have done, AP classroom questions, just any resource that I can find and I can cut up into pieces. I lay them all out on a table, face down. I tell them to get into groups of two.
CJ, who are you working with? You win, Hannah, ding, ding, ding.
I think it's really beneficial if you have someone to talk to, especially with AP precalculus.
You get to take one problem at a time. Go!
When she said go, we would all run up and get one of our questions, and we'd race back to our tables as fast as we could and do the problems. We scramble up to her and try not to elbow each other out of the way, and she'll look at her answer key and be like, yes or no.
Is this one C?
Yes.
Okay.
If they have it right, they get to put their name on the board. It allows me as the teacher, when they're bringing me problems, to see the ones that they're getting right and the ones they're getting wrong right away. So when I say no, I'm in my mind going, that's problem 13. And then if I see problem 13 four or five times, I know that's something that I need to hit harder with them.
No.
Wow. So it's feedback for them if they're getting it right or getting it wrong, but it's also feedback for me because it's like, where's the misconception?
I think it's a really good gauge for Ms. Feehan to see what she needs to teach a bit more.
Yes. Yes. Yes.
Eventually, the squares will fill up, and then you get to start erasing other people's squares, which is when I think it gets very interesting.
Once all 100 squares are taken, the kids still have to put their name on the board, but the only way to do it is to take someone else's name off.
In other classes, we really don't do this sort of thing. We just do our assignments.
It's a lot more high energy, a lot more fun. I certainly got a lot of steps in going to and from my table. I think it was a good review of the midterm and a helpful preview of the AP test because it gives you the AP problems in a way that's less stressful than the test.
It also benefits my kids that take things a little bit slower because they know, hey, if I only do five problems and this person is doing 10, it's okay. Because a winner is based on pure luck.
Okay, A, 85 A.
But it isn't gonna stop a kid from doing 100 problems.
So C.
Tick, 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 tick.
The activity concluded by Ms. Feehan picking a random number.
After 15, 20 minutes, I will take a number generator on my calculator and have a random integer from 1 to 100.
96. Oh my god.
Isn't that us? You won again!
Whoever wins, they're the grand champions and they think that's the best. I don't ever see my kids any more engaged than when they're in competition with each other. I thrive on the chaos and the competitiveness of these kids.
Good job, guys.
You would have been tripled.